Day of the Dead, the Mexican celebration of life and death, isn't the same as it used to be when it started around 2,000 years ago.
But then it'll be a little bit more of an artistic interpretation, or it could have other elements of social activism too.
Jacobo Lovo is the artistic director of Latino Art Incorporated at the United Community Center. He says while Day of the Dead is still deeply rooted in history and tradition, some offertory displays, or ofrendas, look different than they used to 2,000 years ago.
We have a beautiful ofrenda created by Mothers Against Gun Violence that commemorates loved ones of young African-American males that have been gunned down in our city.
Which shows that ofrendas don't have to be for just immediate family members. Plus, as long as you respect the culture and history of Day of the Dead, Lobo says you can fuse other cultures into an ofrenda.
In Hawaii, ohana means family. So why not have a Hawaiian ofrenda?
This sort of change isn't new. Lobo says about 500 years ago, Day of the Dead was influenced by Christianity when the Spanish conquistadors came to the Americas.
Because the Aztecs were already celebrating the Day of the Dead before then. They had their own religious practices. When they were forced to convert to Catholicism, they had to look for ways to continue celebrating the tradition.
And you may have seen these well-dressed skeletons before too.
But her first appearance was in 1913.
As a political cartoon in an independent newspaper, the author...
He was poking fun of the rich for being, you know, very classist.
And it's become one of the most iconic Day of the Dead symbols. All this doesn't mean Day of the Dead is drastically changing. Rather, it's acknowledging the celebration's traditions and history are multifaceted. And as Lovo says, in regards to the more modern and artistic interpretations, as long as it's done respectfully and appropriately, these alternative renditions are okay.
If we have people who are really connecting with the idea of celebrating a loved one and paying tribute to their memory through this tradition, then that's something a little bit more beautiful and a lot more deep.
In Milwaukee, James Groh, today's TMJ4.